systematic approach to problem solving. Next is the content of the basic education science curriculum. It is the curriculum that encompasses diverse scientific disciplines. In physics, topics may cover motion, forces, and energy. An example could be studying Newton's laws of motion and applying them to real-world scenarios, such as understanding the forces involved in simple machines. Example, in chemistry, students might delve into the properties of elements. The curriculum could include exploring the periodic table and conducting experiments to observe the reactions of different elements, fostering an understanding of chemical properties. The structure naman, the curriculum is structured with a learner-centered and inquiry-based approach, often employing constructivist pedagogy. It follows a spiral progression where concepts are introduced at a basic level and revisited with increasing complexity over different grade levels. Example, in earth sciences, the curriculum might introduce basic concepts of geology in early grades. So as the students progress, they revisit these concepts with a deeper understanding, exploring topics like plate tectonics, seismic activity, and geological formations. This structured approach ensures a gradual and comprehensive development of scientific knowledge. Next is importance of science education to national development. Some education plays a crucial role in national development for several reasons. First is innovation and technological advancement. Science education fosters a culture of innovation by equipping individuals with the knowledge and skills needed to develop new technologies. A scientifically literate population contributes to advancements in various fields, leading to technological innovations that drive economic growth. Number two is economic competitiveness. Nations with a strong foundation in science education are better positioned to compete globally in the knowledge-based economy. A skilled workforce in science-related fields attracts investments and promotes sustainable economic development. Number three is problem solving and critical thinking. Science education cultivates critical thinking skills and problem solving abilities, which are essential for addressing complex challenges in various sectors, including healthcare, environment, and industry. Number four is environmental sustainability. Science education raises awareness about environmental issues and promotes sustainable practices. Informed citizens and professionals can contribute to the development and implementation of eco-friendly policies and technologies. Number five, resource management. Scientific knowledge is essential for effective resource management, including agriculture, water resources, and energy. Sustainable resource utilization is critical for long-term national development and resilience against global challenges. And last is social development and informed citizenship. Science education empowers citizens to make informed decisions about scientific and technological advancements, promoting responsible citizenship. Last is the historical development of science in the Philippines. Ito na yung historical and opportunities. In the post-World War II era, the Philippine government intensified efforts to improve science education, leading to establishment of science-oriented high school and colleges. Despite these developments, several challenges persist in teaching science in the Philippines. One major issue is the inadequate resources, including outdated laboratory equipment and insufficient teaching materials. opportunities exist for improvement. Government initiatives, partnerships with private sectors, and advancement in technology can address resource limitation. So, science education aims to develop scientific literacy among the Filipino learners that will prepare them to be active and engaged citizens in the society. As a whole, the K-12 science curriculum is a learner's alert and inquiry-based, emphasizing the use of contact-based pedagogy, game teaching, concept and skill in life science. Physics, chemistry, and earth science are presented with increasing levels of complexity from one grade level to another. In spiral progression, that's paving the way to a deeper understanding of core concepts. The science curriculum promotes a strong link between science and technology, including indigenous technology, that's preserving our country's cultural heritage. K-12 Curriculum Guide Science 2016. Science education in the Philippines is strategically designed to foster scientific literacy among Filipino learners, aiming to equip them as proactive and engaged citizens in society. The K-12 Science Curriculum is characterized by a learner-centered and inquiry-based approach, where the emphasis on constructivist pedagogy enhances the teaching process. The curriculum unfolds with a deliberate spiral progression, systematically introducing concepts and skills to life science. This intentional progression ensures that the complexity of these concepts increases as students move through different grade levels. This spiral structure aims to build a solid foundation of knowledge while facilitating a continuous deepening of understanding as learning progress. Furthermore, the curriculum recognizes the crucial link between science and technology. It goes beyond conventional approaches by incorporating indigenous technology, thereby preserving the rich cultural heritage of the country. This integration not only enhances the relevance of the curriculum, but also acknowledges the importance of indigenous knowledge in the broader context of science and technology. The overreaching goal of this science education framework is to empower Filipino learners with a comprehensive understanding of science principles, encouraging critical thinking and active participation in social affairs. By intertwining science, technology, and cultural heritage, the curriculum strives to produce well-rounded individuals who can contribute meaningfully to the dynamic challenges of the contemporary. Next.
This curriculum is designed around the triple mix of learning science, understanding, and applying scientific knowledge in the settings as well as global context, performing scientific processes and skills, and developing and demonstrating scientific attitudes and values. The occupation of these domains is facilitated using the following approaches: multi-interdisciplinary approach, science, technology, society approach, contextual learning, problem, issues-based learning, and injury-based approach and approaches are based on constructivism, social cognition, learning model, learning style and theory, and brain-based learning.
So, this curriculum is structured to encompass three key learning domains in science education: the application of scientific knowledge in both local and global contexts, the mastery of scientific process and skills, and the cultivation of the demonstrations of scientific attitudes and values. To facilitate the acquisition of these domains, the curriculum employs various approaches, including a multidisciplinary approach, a science-technology-society approach, contextual learning, problem-issue-based learning, and an inquiry-based approach. These strategies are grounded in educational theories such as constructivism, social cognition learning model, learning style theory, and brain-based learning. Next is explain ko na lang. In the K-12 curriculum, the deliberate interconnection of science content and processes underscores a comprehensive approach to scientific education. By structuring the curriculum around real-life situations and problems that pique learners' curiosity, the intention is to not only impart knowledge but also to inspire a genuine appreciation for science. This approach taps into the inherent inquisitiveness of students, fostering a proactive engagement with scientific concepts. The overreaching goal of the K-12 science curriculum is multifaceted. It seeks to empower learners to not only grasp basic science concepts but also to apply scientific inquiry skills effectively. Beyond mere comprehension, the curriculum aspires to instill in students a sense of scientific attitudes and values. This includes the ability to critically approach problem solving, innovative solutions that have societal benefits, contribute to environmental protection and resource conservation, and promote the integrity and wellness of individuals. Moreover, the curriculum aims to equip learners with the capacity to make informed decisions, engaging them in discussions on pertinent issues at the intersection of science, technology, and the environment. This holistic approach aligns with the broader educational philosophy outlined in the K-12 guide, in the K-12 curriculum guide for science, emphasizing not just the acquisition of knowledge but the cultivation of skills, attitudes, and values essential for responsible and active participation in an ever-evolving world shaped by science. So next is the domains of learning sciences, theoretical foundation approach to teaching science curricular features. Understanding and approaching scientific knowledge. Performing scientific process and skills, developing and demonstrating scientific attitudes and values. Next is multi-interdisciplinary approach, science, technology, society approach, and contextual learning. Next is multi-interdisciplinary approach, science, technology approach, contextual learning, constructivism, social cognition learning, model learning style theory, brain-based learning, learner-centered, inquiry-based, progression of concepts and skills, intertwined science, context and self-process problem-based. Last is curricular features. Understanding and applying scientific knowledge, performing scientific process and skills, developing and demonstrating scientific technology and values. Organizing the curriculum around situations and problems that challenges the learner's curiosity, motivates them to learn, and appreciate science. Last is developing and demonstrating scientific attitudes and values. To solve problems critically, innovate beneficial products, protect the environment and conserve resources, enhance the integrity and wellness of people, make informed decisions, and engage in discussions of relevant issues that involve science, technology, and environment. Last is the guiding principles of science. First is science for everyone. Science is for everyone emphasizes the idea that scientific knowledge and exploration should be accessible and inclusive to people of all backgrounds, irrespective of age, gender, ethnicity, or socioeconomic status. It promotes the notion that anyone can engage with and contribute to the scientific process. Number two, science is both content and process. Science as content refers to the body of knowledge and information accumulated through systematic observation, experimentation, and analysis. This includes established scientific theories, principles, facts, and concepts within various scientific disciplines. While science as process involves the methodological approach scientists use to explore, understand, and explain the natural world. This process includes making observations, formulating hypotheses, conducting experiments, collecting data, analyzing results, and drawing conclusions. Number three, the school science should emphasize depth rather than breadth, coherence rather than fragmentation, and use of evidence in constructing explanation. Focusing on depth involves a thorough exploration of specific topics, allowing students to delve deeply into concepts rather than skimming the surface of meaning. This approach promotes a more profound understanding of the principles. Coherence rather than fragmentation. Prioritizing coherence involves presenting information in a connected and logical manner, ensuring that students can see the relationships between different concepts. This approach helps build a more integrated and holistic understanding of the subject. Number four, the school science should be relevant and useful. The school science should be relevant and useful by ensuring that the content and skills taught are applicable to real-world situations and the daily lives of students. This approach aims to engage students more effectively and demonstrate the practical importance of scientific knowledge. Last is, the school science should nurture interest in learning. It is creating an environment that sparks curiosity, encourages exploration, and fosters a genuine passion for understanding the natural world. This approach aims to cultivate a lifelong love for learning and a positive attitude towards science.